disorders lead. Death is that maddening sensation of someone embedded in your skin and your breath, and also absent. And this, I think, is why the wind whistles through the holes in my flesh, singing the absence from my bones made flutes. Such a final act, which yet lives in me until I die, and the bone flutes of my children take up the song. Farewell Symphony. I had to write a poem, make a map to break out of the family home. The layers were so great, I felt both suffocated and comforted by history. And because it revolved around love, music, death, sex, the themes I live most, it was potent like a drop of fire. Like viewing the scene through a glass jar, perhaps one my mother filled with blackberry jam. And I feel like I've traded that house for this one, so loaded it is. The belongings of a past, not always my own. The furniture of the future, but chosen for what beauty it brings. Not a refuge from abandonment and hatred, like the middle house, but nonetheless powerful, though my wishes for it are simple. Let it be the place of love, of beauty, of rest and calm. Let it bring those within the peace I wish to spread. Let it be the stage for music and passion and the deepest of soul connections. Let it nurture the children and my lover as if from my body. Let it be filled with sunlight, a daily sunrise on view. May they be the perfect spot for moonlit lovemaking, the fragrance of coffee, the rustle of books, the rhododendrons blazing through the bathroom windows. Roses and herbs to nourish in all the ways, and a place for the beasts to lie in the warm. Let it hold my writing and my heart when fragile. Let it see triumphs, but also mourning if needed. And let it be another of the beginnings, because I am tired of endings against which I cannot fight, nor even rail. But I do glimpse such bliss in the moments now, and I should like to become accustomed to that. Let me write a poem of heart-starting beauty. May it range like eagles over sunsets, pull down stars, fathom oceans, breathe life into the dead. Let it end wars, regrow limbs, mend hearts, raise children without violence, offer hands to women and the poor. May it make buses clean, and run to timetables. It will tune instruments, write perfect music, remember all the movie titles I cannot, always be a perfectly neat drawer in the kitchen where once chaos reigned. May it make my keys sit always in view, always where I should have left them, and not 6 inches to the right, rendered invisible. Let it move across the earth, bringing back the winter and the whales, nourishing polar bears, uncovering thylacine and panthers. But I don't think poetry will do this, unless poetry is love made powerful, so we see it in each eagle, each child, and ourselves.
Yeah.